going on, everybody, and welcome to the beatmakers.net. Now, this probably, you haven't seen my face in a little while since probably the other beat breakdown videos from a couple years ago. I haven't really been showing my face too much, but today you get to see me. Here I am. So today we're gonna basically just, I'm just gonna show you guys just, you know what I'm saying, just a simple video of my setup and, you know what I'm saying, the things that I use here when I'm creating beats or, you know, when I'm creating my tutorials and creating loops and things like that for the producer. So this video is just basically just for that, just to show you the studio setup so you guys know what I use, and for all the beginners out there that want to know what I use and things like that, this is for that. All the links to everything that I use will be in the description, so you guys can go check that out as well. Secondly, before we switch over to me showing you the whole setup and everything, I just want to let you guys know I appreciate all of you guys who watch the videos, from the likes, the subscribers, everything, man. It's just an honor to even be in the position that I am, to be here, to be able to help you guys out and to show you the things that I use on a daily basis. So, like I said, here we are. This is just a studio tour. Basically, I'm just going to show you the setup here. So make sure you like, comment, subscribe. For any other type of videos that you guys want to see, things like that, any suggestions, leave them in the comments below. So yeah, let's go ahead and get into it. But real quick, if you guys need any sounds, loops, MIDI kits, drum kits, anything like that, boatloadkits.com. We have everything you need, from loops to stem packs to MIDI packs, all of that. So boatloadkits.com is where it's at. Go check it out. And let's get into the studio tour. Ah. All right, everybody, we're back. So, this is the setup. Like I said, I know you guys are probably expecting more, but this is it, man. It's mad simple. There's not too much going on. Right over here, we have the HS8 studio monitors, the Auralex foam to go under them, just to, you know, trap the bass up and keep it from rumbling all over the place. Those HS8s are really good. They have a really great response to them. Not too much going on with those. But I love them, you know what I mean? So they're my trusty eights over here. I got this little thing I've just put up just to, I don't know, help the sound from reaching in that corner back there. And we have the AKG here. This is the P120, mad basic mic. Not too much going on with this mic here. Like I said, it's just a simple mic just to get me by to do my tutorials and things like that. Then I have a pop filter to go there. Then we have the Audio Technica M20s here. These are just for recording the artist, not for mixing or anything like that. That's just so that the artist can have something to listen to and it'll still be quality. And then, you know, of course, the mic stand and things like that. Then we have the M50s right here, which I use for mixing and things like that. These are really, really good. I came from the Sennheiser HD280s, I think they were called, the 280 Pros, I think that's what they're called, but coming from those to these, I honestly feel like the Sennheisers were slightly better, but I like these two. These are really great. And we go over here, here's my screen, just a 19-inch TV screen, not too much going on here, real basic. That's hooked to this laptop here, which is my HP. And this is a i7. I got a terabyte hard drive in there. 16 gigs of RAM is what it will let me max out to. And then I have a 300 gig external drive here that holds everything as far as like beats and things like that. And then I have a 2 terabyte external here that I use for my backup. I'm gonna get another one, but right now that's all I use for everything. Here we have the Scarlett 8i6. This is by Focusrite, as you can see right there. Focusrite Scarlett 8i6, 8 input, 6 output. We have 2 in the front, and then there's a bunch of inputs in the back. And then, you know, your volume and your headphone volume, things like that. And then here, most basic, I've had this for years. This is my KeyStation 49. Not too much going on with that. That's real basic, just to get the job done. And then I have this this desk here. This desk is by OnStage Stands. Not too much going on with this desk. Pretty basic, like I said, but it gets the job done. You know, then I have my sustain pedal down here. Sorry about all that, the cables and stuff. There's just terrible cable management. Once I get a better desk, I think I'm gonna invest in something that's gonna go on the wall back there, to basically just keep all the cables in one central location and then just slide up to the desk to where they need to go, or down to the, you know, I have a
Furman power conditioner back here that I keep everything plugged into. That surge protector down there is just to hold like the light, the screen, and then my laptop plug. But that's pretty much all that that surge protector holds. Then I have a lamp back there. And up here, I just basically have a board that, you know, is just things that I need to do for the month. This is my monthly task list. Then I have my calendar for the month as well. This basically, I just write down all the things I need to do for the month. But this is the task list as far as, you know, online stuff, and then things that we need to do in the studio itself. So that's pretty much the setup. There's not too much going on. It's real basic. So like I said, if you guys want any of these, you know, any of this equipment here, you guys can, you know, check all this out in the link in the description below. And as well over here, I have records. And that's pretty much it right there. So that's the setup, guys. That's it.
All right, so that is the setup. That is everything that I have. That is everything that I use on an everyday basis. There's not too much going on at all. Like I said, you really don't need a lot to really get a quality product. It's really about this and this up here. As long as you know how to use these two items and this, you're good. You know what I mean? You're good. You don't need the most expensive equipment to make the best music. It's really about these, this, and being able to understand and read things and things like that. So as long as you're using those, you're good. Like I said, again, if you guys want to check out any of this equipment, check in the link is in the description for every single piece that I use in my lab myself. So I hope you guys like this video. Again, please like, comment, subscribe. It really means a lot to me when you guys do that. And as well as leaving comments and asking lots of questions. I love helping you guys out. I love giving away free game. And like I said, if you guys need any loops, MIDI kits, samples, things like that, boatloadkits.com is where it's at. That's where all of the custom sounds are, all of the custom presets, things like that. So if you guys are liking those, definitely head over there. And until next time, as I always say, peace.